Welcome to Top Tips Friday. After popular demand, today I'm going to show you how to ride and set up a raised pole work exercise. So to start, you need three poles in a straight line on the center line, set up on a 4.5 step distance like we have always done with our trot poles. These are simply our introductory poles to the main part of the exercise. If I had more poles, I would have three more on the other side of the exercise in the same place, set up in the same way. So I've set the poles up about 15 meters from the exercise, but equally it doesn't have to be specific. Today I'm going to be using my pony Kenko for this exercise. She's 14.2. So for raised poles, I've got the distance set up again, 4.5, so that it's nice and easy for her and it's not too much of a stretch. If you've got a larger horse, have somebody on the ground, start with them at 4.5 or 5 pigeon steps, and then adjust them accordingly depending on your horse's stride length. So as you can see, I've got these poles on the side of the exercise set up slightly on a curve. That means that the inner edge, the edge nearest the center line, is slightly closer together than the furthest outside. So you want to judge a little bit by eye with the curve. I've got it set up so that you can ride on a 10 meter circle around both outer edges of the exercise. But the most important thing is that always between the poles is 4.5 for Kenko. So as you can see, I've got wings on the outer edge of this exercise. If I was to only have them raised in the middle, it would mean that she might fall out, whereas the wings really help to keep her centered and keep her traveling on the curve through the poles. So if you're riding a younger or greener horse, you can always just take the pole off and leave it on the ground, leave the distance the same, it'll be okay, and just let them work through it a bit more confidently, and then you can pop it back up when they're feeling nice and comfortable and then work through the exercise again. That is why it's so important to have somebody on the ground when you're doing pole work or jumping exercises, so you can keep altering the exercise as you go rather than setting it up and that being that. So now we've got the technical bit sorted, I'll go and grab Kenko and I will show you a few different ways that you can ride through this exercise. So there are lots of different ways to ride this exercise. You've got the straight line. You've got the straight line followed by the curve. So you ride through your three poles, you look up to where you want to end up, so on that curve around the poles, and then you keep your eyes focused on the bend. You ride the horse with left bend or with right bend, and you keep that line traveling before and after the poles. All the time when you're riding this exercise with raised poles, with just plain trot poles, the idea is we want the horse using the middle of their back and their core. So having them stretching down, taking the rein down and away from you is a really important thing to be working on. Variations that you can use is using the two outside setups of poles. You can ride a 10 meter circle on the exercise. Really make sure you keep the inside bend and look where you're traveling, keeping the impulsion, making sure the horse stays in rhythm the whole time. This exercise is great for younger or older horses. Just make sure that you vary it according to their experience level. And always make sure that you've got somebody to help you on the ground so that they can adjust it accordingly as you're working. So there you have it guys, a really nice raised pole exercise. I hope you liked it. If you did, like my page and you can see lots more videos, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.
Never danced like this before. We don't talk about it. Dancing on to